This is Chris with Splunk Education. You may know you can restrict access to your Splunk environment using predefined roles such as user, power user, and admin. But did you know you can also create custom roles? Custom roles in Splunk allow you to restrict user access to defined subsets of data. Please note that an admin role is required when defining custom roles, so make sure you have proper access in your environment before continuing. In this video, we'll be working with data from two offices located in San Francisco and London. We want users in those offices to be able to manage their own data without having to manually exclude data they don't need. So we'll set up roles limiting them to specific hosts. We will define this role based on the existing user capabilities, with search constraints limiting them to a specific index and host. From the Splunk home screen, we open the Search and Reporting app and search the web index. As you can see, our search returns three hosts, www1, www2, and www3. We know that www1 and 2 are servers located in San Francisco, while www3 is in London. We only want our users to have access to data from one location, so we'll create a user role that defines which servers to search. From the Settings menu, we select Roles. From here, we can edit existing roles, view their capabilities in Index Inheritance, or clone an existing role. We will first define a new role, then create a new user with the capabilities of that role. We want this role to only search hosts located in San Francisco, so we'll name this role SF_user. The first step, inheritance, allows us to automatically assign capabilities from an existing role. We want this new role to have all the capabilities of a user, so we add user as a selected role. One quick note, the selected role with the broadest permissions will be used to select capability, so if admin and user are both selected, the new role will have all the capabilities of the admin role. The Capabilities tab displays and allows us to add available capabilities to our new role. The Inherited column shows us which capabilities are already a part of this role from the predefined selection we made in the last step. The Indexes tab allows us to restrict this role to specific indexes. The Wildcards option gives us a quick way to select similarly named indexes by appending a wildcard to a partial index name. If we enter the letter W with a wildcard and click Add, we see that the web and Win Audit indexes have been added to this role. While we do want to restrict some data for our users, our goal in this demonstration is only to exclude a specific host from one index, while allowing unrestricted access to the rest of the data in the deployment. We choose to include all non-internal indexes. Now it's time to restrict our searches. We can manually add search filters or use the search filter generator to select values. Entering a field name under Indexed Fields will auto-populate its values below. This list of values can be filtered to better select your intended search criteria. If you do not see the values you're looking for, don't worry. To populate this menu faster, Splunk defaults to only include values from the last 60 seconds. We can change this in the Indexed Field and Values Time Range dropdown. We see that our concatenation option and generated search filter have automatically populated. Once we click Add to Search Filter, we can click Preview Search Filter Results to verify that our search is performing as expected. Clicking Host in the field sidebar, we confirm that we are not seeing results from our London host. Please note that by default, this search is also run over the last 60 seconds, so you may need to expand the time range to further verify the results that are returned. Our results look good, so we'll close this tab and click Create. To test our new role, we will create a new user. From the settings menu, we select Users, then click New User. We give our user a name and password. In the Assign Role section, we add the role we just created and delete the default user role. While it may be a best practice to require users to change their password upon login, we will deselect this option for this test user. The remaining default options look good, so we click Save. We now log in as the user we just created. Open the Search and Reporting app, then repeat our original search. Now when we search for events in the web index, only results from the www1 and www2 hosts are included. To learn more, we recommend you check out the documentation, watch additional videos at our Splunk How-To channel, and register for courses with Splunk Education. Thanks for watching.